It was really years ago at this point that Kevin Feige, I believe in 2014, gave us that presentation that lined up all the upcoming Marvel films, including Infinity War Part 1 and Part 2 at the time, and there was more interesting things he told the press, such as the fact that they aim to make most future Marvel films crossovers with other heroes. So let's talk about this effect and what this could mean. Now, of course, with the Marvel Studios slate expanding, Marvel Studios getting bigger by the year, there's no slowdown. There's only going to be more and more new franchises and more heroes. And of course, some of them end up falling to wayside, right? We've seen Doctor Strange, for example. His film, by the time the sequel's out, it's going to be like, what, 5, 6, 7 years between films? That's a lot. For most, this would be a franchise killer. For example, look at the Star Trek brand, right? But Marvel Studios figured out a way to use these characters in other films and have them kind of be in the back of your brain, right? You always remember these characters, so when they show up, you're like, oh, I've seen that character so many times, it doesn't feel like it's been 5+ years. They did this with Thor between the second and the third film. So to me, looking at it, one thing that kind of got me intrigued about the future of the MCU was him saying that, and then recent rumors about potential crossover, such as the one where people are talking about Deadpool and Spider-Man. It's like, I don't know, that probably won't happen. But there is a possibility that you could make Marvel team-up films. And if you guys remember, there's an old Marvel label, Marvel Team-Up, where in like the entire comic, the point of the comic was to give you stories that unite two characters together to be like, hey, did these sell? I don't know, do they? Will they? And they worked. They sold. They worked a whole lot of sales, considering they keep bringing it back and, it keeps making money. Now, obviously, crossovers, characters meeting up, always drives sales. That's why comic book events are so prominent, right? It's like, oh, okay, I read Batman, I might not read Superman. But then you're like, oh, wait, there's an event, it's crossing them over. I gotta read Superman now to know what's happening. That's why you see comic book sales for these events always raise other numbers from the issues that are alongside of them, right? It's a marketing tactic. You could use this. And we've talked about before how they've said they want to explore more crossovers. They want to go down that route. And if people want it, they'll give it to us. So realistically, you know, you're looking at things Bob Iger said in the past. If Netflix characters are popular, we'll bring them to films, sure. Daredevil, we don't know where he's going to end up, but he's going to end up as a whole under the Disney brand in like a year and a half. So there is a possibility there you can make a Marvel team-up that literally sees like Spider-Man and Daredevil team up in a film, right? And it doesn't necessarily have to be Spider-Man 3. It can be a film that's a side thing. Same thing with Deadpool. And I think that's an idea that they should explore and probably will to a degree. What do you guys think?